Hi guys, hello, Mary Meets everybody, it's Michelle Marie Delaney. It's October 17th, 2019, and today, of course, is a wet, soggy, rainy day here in Winston, Connecticut. And today I thought we would talk briefly about Windows 10. I did manage to get it installed using Bootcamp on the Mac Pro. Yeah, I say, the evaluation copy of Windows 10, which is the one that is not tweakable, customizable, or adjustable. Maybe I'm not as dramatic as I, Justine, but when it comes to Windows 10, I feel really out of my, I really feel lost, because it's, it's like, it's waking up. All right. It's just completely different than what I'm used to with Mac OS. I sat there and puttered around it, trying to figure out some of the overlays and the things in the task manager. I figured I had to do some things, but I don't really think it's any faster than Mac OS X because OS X or Mac OS because it makes me feel like El Capitan is better, and it is because I'm used to it, obviously. But even so, the one thing about Windows 10 that really kind of bothers me to no end is the fact that the thing is the customizability is being, it's almost like it's being distributed like shareware or crippleware. I don't like crippleware. At least I can say it's not expireware, which is another thing I hate even more than crippleware is expireware. So, I set it up. It took a lot longer to get Skype to work than it does on my Mac. The Skype program was taking its sweet ass time just to load, and I had to ask myself the very good question, why was Skype taking so long to start? Considering the fact that Skype on my Mac only takes like about 5 seconds from click to start. On Windows, at first it got stuck because it turns out that it was doing some downloading stuff in the background. It had nothing to do with Windows, but it had to do with Microsoft updates. But it just wasn't very good at all for me. Do I still have it installed on the Mac? I do. Because one of the things we're going to be testing it with is for game playing. Last night I also looked to see what kind of games were available for the Mac, either on High Sierra or on El Capitan from the Apple Store. And there were some games. But until the video cards from Skynet comes in, I can't really play any of them because my video card is too mediocre to play them. What happens if Skynet doesn't come through with the card? Well, then we just buy the card we were going to buy anyway, which is the NVIDIA card. And now we can get the ones that use 6-pin power connectors because they're about the 6-pin power cables. And I still want to get the ATI card, the NVIDIA card that can boot the Mac. And because the difference with ones that have the Mac EFI boot and the ones that don't, in price, sometimes is really not that much. And other cards, it's outrageous. But so we'll have to see what goes with that. I wanted to get a laptop, and we talked about that. I wanted to get a MacBook. I still kind of want that. And maybe get a USB Logitech camera that I can use. I'm in MacBook, or maybe figure a way to mount on this stand here that I'm using for my phone so that I can read the chats and the comments and stuff directly. I think that would be a great idea for the future. So, we'll have to see how that works. I noticed that we had we're up to 41 subs yesterday on this channel. And I guess some of the people didn't find the channel really worth their excitement. I'm sorry about that. Sometimes that happens. This channel is still being created. And some of the other people asked me if we could do a live show during weekdays. Let me make it clear. I said once a week. Saturday was the most common day that people seem to have agreed on at answered my question. Nobody else had anything else good or bad to say about Saturday. So we are going to have our live streams on Saturday at 1 o'clock Eastern, 6 p.m. UK time. And that's the one day a week that is officially scheduled. Maybe I might do a surprise one or two another days. But there's really not too many reasons to have too many surprise live streams any other days. Because no one shows up to them, because no one knows where they are. Because right now with four channels, my channel, my three channels, and Lumi's channel, the live streams have been on Lumi's channel. And it's going to be on Lumi's channel this week. And because, like she says, it's not hurting her channel any, and it's actually helping her channel to grow a little bit, which is nice, and she likes that. And then maybe in the near future we will be moving the live streams to this channel once we get more people showing up in the channel and clicking the bell and becoming members of this channel. It would make sense to start doing live streams in here, because right now we're not even getting comments on these videos. Very few comments come in on these videos, so and the viewership on these videos are lower because no one actually is coming in here. Because I think a lot of people don't even know about this channel. So, I mean, what are you supposed to do? If you're going to try to create a channel that's going to reach out to everybody, and no one knows you because you moved your shop and you didn't put up in the storefront where a moving sign, how in the hell is anyone supposed to know where you are? So basically, you got to set up a whole new presence and a whole new location. Then you're going to go, it's just like what Louis Preston was talking about in the shop. When he moves the shop, he's going to make sure that people begin to understand that he's moving the shop to a new location so that they can actually find his store. That's the reason why I've been sharing these videos out with people on Facebook and Twitter. And several of the social media networks, so that you know where I am. That makes sense? Think about it. You're going to be sending out, you're going to be on a YouTube channel, you're going to be covering channel videos from all over the country. You're going to have to find somebody to reach out to those people and say, hey, I'm right here. Sorry you didn't get my notice, I moved my shop, but I'm here. I don't even know if even Google can help me here. I mean, maybe Google can. I mean, if you knew the way I could say it to Google or to YouTube, hey, we moved. You know, what would Google say? Move to where? To where? Probably. We don't have a YouTube channel. We don't have a website because our internet is too sucky to run a website. Despite that, I would love to run a website. Now, the other thing is, see, this is fruit juice, orange fruit chew. Yeah. People are sending with the Halloween candy out. There's a green one, that must be apple. This one looks like it's yellow. I don't know what this one is. That's orange. And then this is green. I think that's lime. But so if you guys see anybody out there and wondering where I am, and wondering if I'm still alive, I'm still on YouTube, the answer is yes, I am. But there's another reason I moved in a location, besides YouTube's fiasco, which is this. On my main channel, it's become a bit of a mess. In so many ways, it's not even funny. Number one, you've got personal videos mixed up with demonstration videos, mixed up with Snow Queen videos, mixed up with videos I like, content I like, playlists that go all the way back to 2011, and tons and tons of live streams that I have basically decided to mark private and basically erased a lot of them because of the fact that I felt that they were a colossal waste of my time. Sorry. It's just an example of what I'm talking about. So it's asking a question that says, why don't you do a live stream because they're boring? I have over 1,900 videos on my home channel, plus videos on this channel, plus videos on my North American Snow Queen channel, plus videos Ian Lumia posted on her channel. Right. There's enough content there between all four channels that you can basically be watching movies and videos for days. There's no reason why you shouldn't be. In fact, maybe that'd be a good idea because at least you can get to know me better. Take a look at all the videos on Welcome to My World channel. Okay, there's not that many. I just share a few in a playlist in the Welcome to My World playlist, a playlist on the vintage. But go to my North American Snow Queen channel. You see a couple of those too from the past. Some of them which you've probably never seen before because they're buried in the middle of nowhere in the catacombs. Then you go to my North Michelle Marie Delaney channel. 1,900 videos. Have you seen every single video I've ever done? I don't think so. So why don't you do yourself a favor and take a look? You might learn something new. You might find something in the, you know, go back all the, you know, from the very early part of history. As far back as YouTube will let you. Because there's a glitch in the system that doesn't let you go far back. I started all the way back out in May of 2011 when actually doing videos. It should be easy enough to find the videos. I even re-uploaded a video that was the video I started out with so that you can find it, so you can see it. And so yes, you can go back and look at those videos. And I'm welcoming you to come back to the videos. I'm welcoming you to come in to be part of the show. I want you to see you have fun. So there's no reason that you should be asking me to do a live show every day thinking that the videos magically vaporize when you're not watching. They're there every day. Love to hear your comments in some of the older videos. I mean, there's so many of them. Don't be afraid to do that. By the way, one other operating system I installed as well as Windows 10 was Linux. I'm a Mac. And the reason I installed Linux is the same reason I installed Windows 10. That is that Linux, however, at least is a little less hostile to me because I'm familiar with Linux because I've been using it for years. So I'm going to be trying to find out new ways to do new things on the computers and things like that. Well, anyway, I'm not going to stream for no 32 minutes like I did yesterday, so I'm going to end this now. Just to tell you, the next few days, the weather is going to be a lot colder at night, so please get ready for that. And be ready for those cold days, because it's going to be pretty cold for the next few nights. Okay? See you later, guys. Bye-bye.